50 dinosaur tales, and 108 more discoveries from the golden age of dinos. By Sabrina Ricci, with Garret Kruger. Narrated by Sabrina Ricci and Garret Kruger. This book is a blend of fiction and fact. All rights reserved. No part of this book may be reproduced, scanned, transmitted, or distributed in any form or by any means without permission. Copyright 2019 Sabrina Ricci. Published by I Know Dino. inodino.com. Dedicated to all our podcast listeners and all dinosaur enthusiasts. Introduction. Thank you so much for purchasing this book. We're all dinosaur enthusiasts here, and it's amazing to live in the golden age of dinosaurs where paleontologists are continuously learning about new dinosaurs and new facts about already known species. Between 2014 and 2018, more than 150 dinosaurs were named. We've been doing the I Know Dino podcast for over 4 years now, and every day I'm inspired by our wonderful, enthusiastic audience. We love learning about dinosaurs, and we love sharing our knowledge with you, and that's why we decided to create one big dinosaur book covering the discoveries from the last few years. To do that, we've combined our stories from the Top 10 Dinosaur series and added new stories and facts from dinosaurs discovered in 2018. Because we're including so many dinosaurs, we thought it'd be fun to sort them by the continent where they were found. In some cases, this was tricky. A few of the dinosaurs found in Russia were from Europe, while others were from Asia. The dinosaurs in the book are organized into two groups, those that we wrote short stories about and those that have lists of facts, all arranged alphabetically. As we mentioned in our Top 10 Dinosaur series, we may never know exactly how dinosaurs lived and behaved, but we still have fun imagining scenes of dinosaurs eating, fighting, and playing. This book is a mix of imagination and research, combining fictitious scenes of 50 of the dinosaurs that made recent headlines with a list of facts about each one to help paint a broader picture. And if you're interested in staying up to date on new discoveries or learning more about the dinosaurs in this book, check out the I Know Dino podcast. Please enjoy, Sabrina. A quick note about the pronunciation of dinosaur names in this audiobook. Dinosaur names are typically a combination of at least two languages. We do our best to pronounce them accurately, but in some cases we've had to go with our best guess. We've also revised our pronunciation of a few dinosaur names since covering them in the podcast. Africa. Ledumahadi mafube, a giant thunderclap at dawn. It's good to be alive. Ledumahadi mafube looks at her surroundings. There is enough vegetation everywhere, so she can always eat her fill. She's one of the largest animals around. No real threats for her to worry about. Ledumahadi is a sauropodomorph, about 14 years old, and an adult in her species. She is about 13 feet or 4 meters tall at her hip and weighs around 26,000 pounds, 12 tons. Her toenail alone is bigger than many of the animals that live in the area. She's large and stout, especially her front legs. So Ledumahadi walks on all fours. However, she likes to stand in a peculiar manner by flexing her limbs instead of using her legs like columns. This gives her a sort of crouching position, which looks a little awkward but is perfectly comfortable. Ledumahadi walks. It's a hot day. The land is very flat, so she can see far into the distance. Something glimmers. Ledumahadi sees water, which reminds her that she's thirsty. She takes quick steps and soon finds herself standing on the shore. There's not much water, and Ledumahadi can see the rocks at the bottom, but she doesn't mind. She plants her feet firmly in the ground and bends her legs, lowering herself to the cool liquid. She laps it up greedily. Once she has her fill, she looks for her next activity. Not too far away is a tall conifer. Most of the leaves have been stripped away by other animals, except for the top of the tree. Fortunately, Ledumahadi is immense, so she knows that she can easily reach the top for a tasty snack. Ledumahadi makes her way to the tree. Standing at the base is a small Heterodontosaurus tuckeye. It's only about 5 feet, 1.5 meters long, and most of the length is in its tail. Heterodontosaurus gives Ledumahadi a curious look. Ledumahadi doesn't pay the little dinosaur much attention and stands up on two legs. She leans on the trunk of the tree with her two forelimbs and stretches her long neck. She opens her mouth and bites a mouthful of leaves. As she chews, she looks down. Heterodontosaurus is staring at her, watching her eat. It looks hopeful, waiting for some of the leaves to fall to the ground. No such luck. Ledumahadi is hungry and efficient. She keeps her mouth closed as she eats, so she does not lose any of her food. Heterodontosaurus keeps looking at her, expectant. It opens and closes its mouth to signal hunger. Ledumahadi finishes chewing. She sees a large branch full of leaves, but it's nearly out of her reach. Ledumahadi grabs the few leaves within her range and pulls them back. She clips the leaves with her teeth and the branch swings back into place. The movement startles a small lizard in the tree. Ledumahadi watches it run from her branch down the trunk and onto the ground. Heterodontosaurus lunges and picks up the lizard in its mouth almost as soon as it's on the ground. Then the pint-sized animal darts away so fast that Ledumahadi doesn't see where it goes. No matter. Ledumahadi moves her head back to the top of the tree and continues to eat.
Facts. Ledumahadi mafube was a sauropodomorph that lived in the early Jurassic in what is now South Africa. Ledumahadi was quadrupedal, but had flexed limbs instead of columnar arms and legs, like its later sauropod relatives. Ledumahadi weighed 12 tons and is one of the earliest known giant sauropodomorphs. The genus name, Ledumahadi, means a giant thunderclap in Sesotho. The species name, mafube, means dawn in Sesotho.
Sefapanosaurus zastronensis, cross lizard. A thin layer of fog covers the area around Sefapanosaurus zastronensis, making the hard dirt under his feet cold. Sefapanosaurus shivers, takes a few gentle steps on all fours, and then rises up onto two legs. He uses his long tail to help balance. The sun is just rising, and Sefapanosaurus' stomach is growling. He stretches his long neck and scours the area for food. Lucky for him, it's not far. A few feet in front of him is vegetation, and Sefapanosaurus reaches out and grabs at it with his hands. On both his thumbs are claws, which he flexes as he shoves plants into his mouth. He is medium-sized, and if he needs to, he can use his claws to defend himself. After devouring a few bites, he glances at the stones below him, looking for the smoothest ones. A ray of sunshine slices through the fog, glimmering against a particularly round stone. Eager, Sefapanosaurus scoops up the rock and swallows it whole. Then he picks up another, and another. These gastroliths will help him to digest his breakfast. Sefapanosaurus has weak teeth, so he relies on the stones to grind up his food. Satisfied, Sefapanosaurus returns his attention to the vegetation and picks off the choicest, most tender leaves he can find. Now that he has some food in his belly, he can afford to be picky. He continues to enjoy his meal. When he is full, he moves to a warmer spot. By now, the sun is making its way through even more of the fog. Sefapanosaurus heads towards a less damp spot near a tree and gets comfortable. One of his favorite pastimes is to nap, especially after eating. He takes a quick look around to make sure no predators are nearby. Enough brush surrounds him that he should be able to hear anyone who approaches him. Feeling safe, he closes his eyes, but he doesn't fall asleep right away. Smaller, harmless animals are starting to wake up, and Sefapanosaurus can hear them. He enjoys the sounds they make, faint squeaks and grunts, as they scamper around him in search of their own breakfast. Sefapanosaurus senses that he is being watched. He lazily opens one eye on his small skull and sees a small furry animal staring at him. Sefapanosaurus snorts and the animal scurries away. Sefapanosaurus closes his eye again, relaxed. He continues to listen to the sounds around him. Then he senses he's being watched again. This time he opens both eyes. The furry animal is back, but this time with a friend. Annoyed, Sefapanosaurus lifts his head. Both animals squeak and duck for cover under some nearby brush. Sefapanosaurus lowers his head and closes his eyes again. He starts to fall asleep, but then he feels a flicker on one of his legs. Startled, he jumps up and flashes his thumb claws, ready for a fight. He sees a blur of two tails, the same furry animals from before. Sefapanosaurus shakes his head to wake himself up, knowing he won't be able to take his nap here. He shuffles along, keeping an eye out for a quieter place to sleep.
Facts. Sefapanosaurus zastronensis was a sauropodomorph that lived in the late Triassic in what is now South Africa. Sefapanosaurus was discovered in the late 1930s in the Elliot Formation in South Africa. The partial skeletons of four individuals were housed at Wits University and at first thought to be the fossils of Ardonyx. Closer studies in 2015 showed the bones were of a new dinosaur genus. One interesting feature of Sefapanosaurus is the cross-shaped talus bone in its ankle. The genus name Sefapanosaurus means cross lizard. The species name, zastronensis, is in honor of Zastron, the town near the Elliot Formation where Sefapanosaurus was found. Find out more in the Inodino podcast, episode 32, Fuquiraptor.
Spinosaurus aegypticus, spiny lizard. The water is murky. Sand and grit stir it up, making it difficult for the giant predator with the 6-foot-tall sail on his back to see. He lowers his mouth into the water, his high nostrils allowing him to breathe easily while the pits on his snout feel for pressure and sense for fish swimming nearby. Nothing moves, or at least nothing worth attempting to catch. The large theropod, Spinosaurus aegypticus, wades into the water. Tired from balancing his long head and neck with his short back legs, Spinosaurus relaxes as he submerges like a crocodile, flexing his flat, webbed feet in the water. The river is shallow, but Spinosaurus paddles quietly, looking for easy prey. An unsuspecting sawfish passes by. It is 25 feet long with jagged teeth. Spinosaurus knows the sawfish will be hard to catch, but the thought of a big meal is enticing. He opens his mouth and tries to rake in the fish with his teeth. Needle-like teeth line the sides of his upper jaw, with more teeth behind them and interlocking teeth at the end of his snout. Spinosaurus tries to bite down with his powerful jaw, but his teeth are not serrated, so he cannot just rip apart the sawfish. The teeth land in the wrong place, near the sawfish's narrow rostrum, which has sharp teeth along it, like a saw. The sawfish struggles, its teeth digging into Spinosaurus. Spinosaurus shakes his long, narrow head and tries to at least stun the sawfish so he can eat it without the struggle. But the sawfish proves to be too strong, and Spinosaurus is forced to let go. The sawfish swims away as fast as it can while Spinosaurus tends to his wounds. The cuts aren't too deep, and Spinosaurus is not that hurt, but he feels the sting of defeat in the pit of his empty stomach. Back on the surface, Spinosaurus keeps only his nostrils above water while he paddles towards land. Only his sail and two large eyes can be seen. A pterosaur lands at the edge of the water and stops to take a drink. Spinosaurus spots the potential meal. Still hungry, Spinosaurus decides to scare and confuse his prey. Spinosaurus raises his sail to create a shadow in the water, arching his back for effect. It works. The pterosaur continues to sit, but more cautiously. Spinosaurus slowly moves towards his prey. When he gets within biting distance, he opens his jaws and snaps down quickly, but not quickly enough. The pterosaur flaps its wings and, with a surge of adrenaline, manages to get away, though not without a souvenir. When the pterosaur fights its way out of Spinosaurus's jaws, it rips out one of Spinosaurus's teeth. The pterosaur
is back. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.